You are watching the Doctalk Show.
Did you know that more than 50% of people, when faced with a medical emergency, will die before reaching hospital? And what's sad to say is that about 80% of such people will have to transport themselves to the hospital. You realize this is quite a critical gap when it comes to dealing with emergencies. Joining me in studio this evening are a team of medical health workers who are specializing in the field of emergency medicine before someone can reach the hospital. This is what is called pre-hospital emergency care. So on my immediate right is Mr. Mugisha Julius, who is a paramedic by training. These are people who specialize in pre-hospital care and helping the patient safely go to the hospital. And to his immediate right is Dr. Hawa Magembe, who is a trauma and emergency medicine health worker. So you're most welcome to the show, Hawa and Julius. So today we're discussing emergency medicine per se, right? Because it's quite a critical field. And I know Uganda, being the young nation it is, you know, some of these things are not quite developed. So people may not know what is emergency medicine. So I'll maybe start with you, Dr. Hawa. What exactly is this you're trying to introduce?
So emergency medicine, or pre-hospital emergency medicine services, is the specialized medical care that's given to very seriously ill patients or dangerously injured patients, okay? And this entails either their transport to the hospital or to the nearby trauma center. But not only that, it also entails the proper care given before reaching the hospital, which is the most important part.
So what exactly, how does that work?
So usually, as in an organized setting, it's supposed to be that if someone is seriously ill, they're supposed, the first line of action is to call for help. Yes. So calling for help entails calling an emergency service. Usually in most countries, this service is nationalized. Although in Africa, we've had difficulty with that because of the way most countries are set up.
It is not yet quite there.
But once they call for help, then that help, like with our system, the way we work, once you call us on the phone, we can give you instructions on what to do and what not to do with the person who's ill as we are on the way to your place or to where you are or where the person is stationed. Because sometimes you may not be with the person, but we can still give you instructions on what to direct, on what to do and things like that.
Okay, very interesting. Yeah. So I'm talking about, yes, you're saying what you can do. So let us understand, Mr. Julius.
Yes.
The company you represent, what exactly is it that you do?
What we do is LIMEA, we bring the hospital to the patient.
Is it like an abbreviation?
Yes.
Is LIMEA?
LIMEA is Life Medical and Rescue International in full, but we abbreviate it to call it LIMEA. It's easier for people to pronounce.
LIMEA.
LIMEA. What we do is we do a comprehensive pre-hospital care service. When you call us, we, in the fight for survival, time is the enemy.
Okay.
So at LIMEA, using the latest techniques and technology, we are able to bring the emergency intensive care unit to the patient. We have the skills to stay and play, not to scoop and run. What the systems use in the current system in Uganda is people like to scoop and run.
What do you mean, scoop and run? Lift
the patient as fast as you can to the hospital, regardless of their physiological condition or regardless of whether they are breathing or they are whatever injury they have.
But it's kind of justified
if the patient is now, for example, is collapsed. Obviously, they have to rush quickly to the hospital. So what are you trying to say?
Now, what I'm saying is that if you rush the patient who is not breathing to the hospital, you're not helping them.
We're not helping them.
Yes. The patient who is not breathing if you rush them to the hospital, you're actually killing them. This is a time-critical incident. Mm. It doesn't matter. What matters is it is essential for someone to start intervening right there and then in order to give them a chance to live. If someone, for example, gets a heart attack and is on ground, they are not breathing, they are not responsive, the most important thing is to start CPR.
So that something.
Yes.
So it doesn't matter if you, even if it's not a doctor, but someone there has to start something.
Absolutely. Yes.
Okay.
It's whether it doesn't matter if it's a professional or any other layman, as long as they are doing that intervention as we come to do the comprehensive interventions, then we are giving that person a chance to live.
Okay.
Statistically, for example, for countries like the Netherlands has 69% survival rate of heart attacks. In Uganda, I don't know the statistics, but probably they are not
the
good one.
You already said that almost half people don't even make it
to
the hospital.
Yes.
So imagine that half number of people who are dying on their way either from home or on their way to hospital, maybe some of them have heart attacks.
Yes. So if you have a situation of like a choking baby, it doesn't help you rushing this baby to the hospital because it's going to take 1 hour with our transportation, with our roads. It's going to take you 1 hour to take that baby to the hospital. In contrary to if you have a choking baby, you will call 0800 330 330, which is our company. And then we shall tell you, look here, put the baby in your palm, turn them on the side, do this, right? Save their lives. Which will take not even more than 5 minutes. Very easy instructions for everybody to understand.
So what Limia is bringing is you're extending that emergency care someone at home can give as directed on the telephone or something.
Yes, we're using the system, a dispatch system that gives, that triages and prioritizes the symptoms to make a call a higher priority. And it also helps us who we send. If the person, let's say, is in a life-threatening or life-changing injury, you really want to send a doctor, you really want to send a critical care paramedic, and you really want to send an intensive care paramedic, and then the equipment to use. Because for us, we are very advanced. We can do emergency surgery, we can do blood transfusion, anesthesia, at the scene of an accident.
So you're doing the care at the accident place, not... So do you also take part in transporting the patient
yes,
to the hospital?
Because what we do in pre-hospital care is we do those interventions. We can't do those other interventions the hospital can do, but we can do those interventions that will give you a chance to live, save your life, stabilize you, make sure that you're now stable enough to go to the hospital for definitive care. So for us, we give you those interventions so that you don't die and then take you to the hospital for definitive care. And not everyone that calls us goes to the hospital.
Okay, very interesting. So we'll come after the break to understand more about how this emergency system works. It's a fairly new concept. I'm not sure. I don't know how many countries in Africa do this system.
We have Botswana.
Mm-hmm.
Ethiopia is picking it up. And Uganda through Limia.
So it's kind of a new thing.
Yes.
Because how we are structured is, if someone falls sick, take to the hospital. All right. We don't think about call for help quickly. As we are talking to the doctor, you can be doing something. Maybe that's how our mindset is needed.
Well, I wouldn't really say it's a new thing. It's more of an ignored concept. Because from time immemorial, if you got a problem, you would first thing call for help. But now people have ignored that concept, and now people see, instead of call for help, they think the idea is to move to help. And yet call for help is always the easier way. Mm. Call for help, whether you have to phone for the help, whether you have to move to a neighbor to call for help, that's easier than moving to the help. Yes.
Okay, so more about emergency care coming right after the break. If you've just joined us, we are talking about emergency care with a team of experts from Limia. Limia is a company in short for Life Medical and Rescue. So they deal with pre-hospital emergency services. These are services that they give to someone if they are faced with an emergency. From the time they fall sick to the time they get to the hospital, That is the area where they're specializing in. So more about this coming right after the break. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
You are watching the Doc Talk Show.